Now we can find through the formula, we can determine the work done. So PdV, so we can determine the work done. Now work done 3 to 1 is a constant volume process. So we know that in a constant volume process there is no change in displacement. So work done equal to 0. So net work done equal to work done 1 to 2, work done 2 to 3, work done 3 to 1. So just to add it, then we can determine the net work done. Now we need to determine the heat transfer process 1 to 2. So they ask in 1 to 2 only. So constant pressure process in 1 to 2. So Q 1 to 2 equal to del U 1 to 2 plus work done. Okay. So the work done we can write U2 minus U1 plus W 1 to 2. So U2 1 is given. So in process 3 to 1 is a constant volume process is given. In a given the U1 minus U3 is given. But here we need to know the U2 minus U1. So here just instead of that, just we are putting the plus 26. So then work done. So just we add it, then we can find out the heat transfer for 1 to 2. Next heat transfer for 2 to 3. So U3, so del U 2 to 3 plus W 2 to 3. So del U 2 to 3 only we can write U3 minus U2 plus work done. So there is no displacement in it, there is no heat transfer, there is no change in internal energy for the constant temperature process. Why? Because that internal energy is the function of temperature. So in a constant temperature process, there is temperature remain constant, so there is no internal energy taken place. So just Q2 to 3 equal to work done 2 to 3. The work done 2 to 3 already we determined. Next one, we need to determine the net work heat transfer. So just add the all the heat, then we find the minus 8282. So work done also same value. So from that we can conclude the third question answer, sum of the work done equal to sum of the heat transfer is proved. Okay, right. Next we move to next problem. Okay, so next process, the gas expanding in a combustion space of reciprocating engine as an initial pressure of 50 bar and the initial temperature of 1623 degrees Celsius. The initial volume is 50,000 mm cube and the gas expands through the volume ratio of 20 according to the law of PV equal to 1.2. So the process in a polytropic process. We need to determine the work transfer and then heat transfer expansion process take. R equal to 270 joules per kh Kelvin, then CV equal to 8000. So you need to convert the units. Okay. So first we need to convert the units. So just write down the given data. So initial pressure P1, then T1 initial temperature, the initial volume is 50,000 mm cube. So you need to convert it into meter cube. So just divide by the 10 to the power each 1000, we just add the minus 3. So here we put the 10 to the power of 9. So we get the 5 into 10 to the power of minus 5 meter cube. Next they give the volume ratio. So it's nothing but a expansion to initial position. So V2 by V1 equal to 20 or V1 by V2 equal to 1 by 20. Then gas constant 270 joules per kg Kelvin, we should convert it into kilojoules per kg Kelvin. The remaining also we need to convert. Now we need to determine the work transfer. So work transfer formula, we know that in a for polytropic process, P1 V1 minus P2 V2 N minus 1. So we don't know the value of P2. So we know the relationship with respect to pressure and volume. P2 by P1 equal to V1 by V2 power N. So N is given 1.25. Substitute the values, then we can determine the P2. Now we substitute into the work done formula, then we get the work done 0.527. Next we need to determine the heat transfer. So we know the formula for heat transfer, Q equal to W plus del U. So del U equal to MCV del T. So MCV, so CV is given, so M also given. So from that we can determine the, we need to determine the T2. So we know the relationship T2 by T1 equal to P2 by P1 N minus 1 by N. So from that we can determine the T2. Now we substitute here. So M value we can determine P1 V1 equal to MRT1. So from that we determine the M1. So for now, if we substitute all the values are here, then we can determine the del u. So substitute in this formula, then we find out the heat transfer for during the process. Okay, right. Now we move to the next problem. A three process cycle operating with a nitrogen gas as a working substance as a constant temperature compression at 30 degrees Celsius with an initial pressure of 1000 kilopascal. Then the gas undergoes a constant volume heating and then polytropic expansion with 1.35 as a index of compression. The gas isothermal compression required minus 67 kilojoules per kg of work. Point out PV and TS diagram, then heat in and out network. The nitrogen CV equal to 0.741 kilojoules per kg Kelvin. Now we can solve this problem. So we know the formula. First we need to write down the given data. The given data are given here. The gas is nitrogen. So constant temperature process. So T1 equal to T2. Now we need to draw here PV and TS diagram. So 1 to 2, what is 1 to 2? Is here is constant temperature process. During the compression, what will happen? It's a process of compression. So what in the during the compression, volume decreases, the pressure is increases. Next 2 to process 3, the process is a constant volume process. Okay, then it also compression, so the pressure is rises. Next 3 to 1 is a polytropic process, expansion. So during the expansion, volume is increases, pressure is decreases. So cyclic process. Similarly, we need to draw a TS diagram. Now we need to determine the heat transfer in and out. From first law of thermodynamics, we know that net heat input equal to net output. So net heat transfer equal to Q1 to 2, Q2 to 3, Q3 to 1. So heat transfer process 1 to 2, we know the isothermal process. So in 1 to 2, Q1 minus 2, W 1 to 2 plus del U. So in a heat transfer constant isothermal process or constant temperature process, that internal energy is 0. Why? Because the internal energy is the function of temperature. So that the internal energy is 0. So Q1 to 2 is equal to work done 1 to 2. So work done 1 to 2 is given in the problem. So we can straight away we can determine the Q1 to 2. Now we need to determine Q2 to 3. So Q2 to 3 is the process of constant volume process. We know the formula for constant volume, MCV T3 minus T2. So T1 we know, so T1 equal to T2. Now we need to determine the T3. So we know the relationship P2 by P3 equal to T3 by T2. So now we substitute the values on here. Now we need to determine the P2, P3, T3. So we know the work done formula for the process of 1 to 2 is a isothermal process, or T1 is nothing but a P1 V1 is there in table. So we can write PV equal to MRT. So MRT. So just we replace with the RT1 ln of P2 by P1. So we know the work done is given in the question. Now we substitute here. Now we determine the P2 value. So the R value we can determine, we need to determine because it's not a constant, because here it's not a air. Here we are using nitrogen. So we know the formula. So the R equal to the gas constant, R equal to universal gas constant divided by molecular weight of the given gas. So RU, universal gas constant is constant, 8.314 divided by the molecular weight of the nitrogen is 28. So just here we are putting 28. So we can determine the R value. Then we substitute here. Then we determine the P2. Now we determine the we know the, again, we know the relationship 2 to 3. P2 by P3 equal to T3 by T2. So here substitute here. So if from that we can determine the T3 value. Now we substitute all the values into the formulas. So again we need to know one more relationship 3 to 1. So this is a polytropic process. Here also we know that T1 by T3 equal to P1 by P3 N minus 1 by N. So substitute the T1 value 307. So we know the formula, unknown value T3 equal to 1.472 P3 in terms of P3. Just a substitute on here. Equal to 100. So P1 is 100 question, given in the question P3. So just to convert it, make the mathematical relationship. Now we can determine the P3. From the P3 we can determine the T3 value. Now substitute the value for 2 to 3 heat transfer MCV T3 minus T2. So all the values we know. So for substitute the in formula, Now we can determine the Q3 formula. So Q3 to 1, heat transfer during the process 3 to 1 is a polytropic process. We know the formula, gamma minus n divided by gamma minus 1 into work done 3 to 1. So work done 3 to 1 already we determined. So gamma value is a constant 1.4, n is 1.3 is given in the question. Now we substitute work done 3 to 1, P1 V1 minus P2 V2 divided by n minus 1. So here we can write instead of P1 V1, just we can know the PV equal to MRT, just replace with R T3 minus T1 divided by N minus 1. Now substitute here, now we can get the value for closures per cage. So we need not to put the mass because we determine the value for per mass cage, per mass. Okay, now we substitute the value again on the formula. Now we determine the heat transfer during the process of 3 to 1. Now we add all the heat. Now we determine the net heat transfer. Net transfer equal to net work done. Now we add all the work done. Now we determine the net work done. Okay. Now we move to the next. So, thank you students. Just subscribe my channel. Then give your valuable feedback. Because I have only a trial version of recording software, so I can record for 10 minutes only. So it takes a lot of time to upload the videos. So I request you all, please subscribe my channel, give your valuable comments and feedbacks. Thank you. Now we are going to see about constant volume process. Constant volume process. Constant volume process. So let consider one vessel. ஒரு vessel எடுத்துங்க. நம்ம குக்கரை எடுத்துங்களே. குக்கரில் நான் என்ன பண்ணுறேன், ஃபுல்லாக உள்ளே சம் மாசஸ் வந்து போட்டுருக்கேன். ஓகேங்களா, மாசஸ் வந்து போட்டுருக்கேன். ஓகேவா, நவ் நீங்கள் ஸ்டவ் வந்து ஆன் பண்ணுறீங்க. ஸோ என்னாகும், வி சப்ளை த ஹீட். குக்கருடைய வால்யூம் வந்து எப்படி இருக்குது, கான்ஸ்டண்டாக இருக்கா? ஸோ வால்யூம் ஆஃப் த குக்கர் ரிமைன் கான்ஸ்டன்ட். ஓகேங்களா, வால்யூம் ஆஃப் த குக்கர் ரிமைன் கான்ஸ்டன்ட். ஓகே, ஸோ வாட் வில் ஹேப்னிங், சம் பீரியட் ஆஃப் டைமுக்கு அப்புறம் என்ன ஆகும், இந்த வெயிட் வந்து மேலே ரைஸ் ஆகுது. ஏன் அது ரைஸ் ஆகுது, உள்ளே வந்து டெம்பரேச்சர் ரைஸ் ஆகுது. டெம்பரேச்சர் ரைஸ் ஆகுதுனா ப்ரெஷர் ரைஸ் ஆகுது. ஒரு பர்டிகுலர் ப்ரெஷருக்கு அப்புறம் பார்த்தீங்கன்னா யூ ஷுட் பி ரைஸ் த வெயிட். அந்த மேலே வைக்கிற டெட் வெயிட் வந்து ஓப்பன் ஆகுது. அப்போது டியூரிங் த கான்ஸ்டன்ட் வால்யூம் ப்ராசஸில் என்ன ஆகுது, ப்ரெஷர் அண்ட் டெம்பரேச்சர்ஸ் ஆர் ரைசஸ். ஓகே, அட் ஏ கான்ஸ்டன்ட் வால்யூம். ஸோ அந்த வெசலில் வந்து பார்த்திங்கன்னா வால்யூம் வந்து எதுவும் சேஞ்ச் பண்ணல. ஸோ அப்போது ஒரு பிவி டயக்ராம் ட்ரா பண்ணலாம். பிவி தென் வால்யூம். ஸோ குக்கருடைய வால்யூம் எப்படி இருக்குது, கான்ஸ்டண்ட்டாக இருக்குது. ஓகேங்களா, ஸோ ப்ரெஷர் மட்டும் என்ன ஆகுது, ரைஸ் ஆகுது. ஃப்ரம் ஸ்டேட் 1 பிஃபோர் சுவிட்ச் ஆன் த ஸ்டவ், ஆஃப்டர் சுவிட்ச் ஆன் த ஸ்டவ். ஸோ ஸ்டவ் ஆன் பண்ணதுக்கு முன்னே எப்படி இருக்குது, உள்ள இருக்க அந்த காய்கறி இல்லை வெஜிடபிள்ஸோ ஏதோ ஒன்று போட்டுருக்கீங்க. அந்த வெஜிடபிளுடைய டெம்பரேச்சர் பார்த்தீங்கன்னா சில்லுன்னு இருக்கும், லைக் சம் ரூம் டெம்பரேச்சரில் இருக்கும் போது. நீங்கள் அதுக்கப்புறம் ஸ்டவ் ஆன் பண்ணதுக்கப்புறம் அது பாயில் ஆக சொல்ல என்னாகும், அவருடைய டெம்பரேச்சர் வந்து வேரியாகும். இட்ஸ் ஸ்டேட் 1 அண்ட் ஸ்டேட் 2. ஓகேங்களா, இப்போது வி நீட் டு டிட்டர்மைன் த அன்னோன்ஸ். ஓகேவா, ஸோ வாட் ஆர் த அன்னோன்ஸ், ஃபஸ்ட்டு வி நீட் டு டிட்டர்மைன் த ஒர்க் டன். ஓகேவா, ஃபஸ்ட்டு வி நீட் டு டிட்டர்மைன் தி ஒர்க் டன். So what is the work done? So work done na namukku enna theriyum, so constant volume process la first we need to determine the work done. Constant volume work done equal to W equal to integral of 1 to 2 P dv. So this is a volume remain constant. So integrating of any volume, integrating of any constant become zero. So work done for constant volume process, pathina work done equal to zero. Why? Because there is no displacement. There is no displacement in process. Okay, Next one, I want to know what is the internal energy. So anything rise in internal energy? Yes, change in internal energy. So internal energy generally needed like a del U is nothing but mass of the gas, specific volume CV, integral of 1 to 2 dt. So here the temperature is rises, right? You know the temperature is rises. So internal energy del U equal to m cv integral of 1 to 2 dt. So just changing the function m cv, the change of temperature is there because before that heat panathukona or temperature ku heat pannadukapra or temperature ku, so it become t2 minus t1. So this is a formula for change in internal energy at a constant volume process. Okay, now I want to know what is the heat transfer. So heat transfer, so from first law of thermodynamics I know Q equal to W plus del U. Okay, so W is 0 for constant volume process, then del U. Okay, this is a function of del U. So for Q is nothing but equal to del U. So what is a del U? M CV T2 minus T1. MCV T2 minus T1. Okay, now I want to know what is the change in enthalpy. Change in entropy. Change in entropy. Okay, change in entropy is a function. So we can see in unit 2 change of entropy. Now we can change in enthalpy. So it's nothing but a del H. So we can write enthalpy is the function of pressure 1 to 2, the function of temperature. So m cp t2 minus t1. Okay, during the process. Now we need to know the relationship between the pressure. Relationship. So what are the relationship? We know the formula P, according to the gas law, P1 V1 by T1 equal to P2 V2 divided by T2. So during the constant volume process, V1 equal to V2 become cancelled. So P1 by T1 equal to P2 by T2. Okay. So this is the relationship. Okay. Now we need to go with the constant pressure process. Constant pressure process. So during the constant pressure process, let take a piston, then piston cylinder. Inside the piston, I am putting some gases. Now I apply here some amount of heat on bottom of the cylinder. What will happen? To raise the temperature, due to rising of temperature, the pressure is increases. Here the pressure remained constant. So what I am going to do, just I am adding the dead weights of top of the piston. So top of the piston, I am adding dead weights when they add. So upon இது வேப் மூவ் ஆகும் பட் த ப்ரெஷர் ரிமைன் கான்ஸ்டன்ட். ஸோ போத் சைட் ஆர் ஈக்லிப்ரியம். ஸோ ஸ்லோலி இட் மூவ்ஸ். ஸோ த ப்ரெஷர் ஆர் சேஞ்ச் பட் இட்ஸ் ஏ வெரி நெக்லிஜிபிள் அமௌண்ட். ஸோ திஸ் ப்ராசஸ் இஸ் கால்ட் எஸ் ஏ கான்ஸ்டன்ட் ப்ரெஷர் ப்ராசஸ். ஸோ இன் பிவி டயக்ராம் வி கேன் ட்ரா பிவி, த வால்யூம் இஸ் சேஞ்ச், ஸோ ப்ரெஷர் ரிமைன் கான்ஸ்டன்ட். ஸோ த வால்யூம் இஸ் சேஞ்ச், V1 V2 then this is a process. So this is a pressure P1 equal to P2. Okay, for in order to determine the work done, so W equal to integral of 1 to 2 P dV. So what is the P dV? So what is the pressure? Pressure is the constant, take him away, then 1 to dV. So if dV integrate panina, we get V. So substitute the limit V2 minus V1. Okay, so this is the formula for work done constant pressure process. Next I want to know what is the internal energy. So change of change in internal energy. Change in internal energy. So this is nothing but del U. We know the formula M Cv integral of 1 to 2 dt. So M Cv T2 minus T1, because temperatures change during the process. So now I want to know the heat transfer Q. So nothing but a heat transfer. So what's the formula for Q equal to W plus del U. W plus del U. So what is the W? W is nothing but P V2 minus V1 plus what is the del U? M Cv T2 minus T1. Okay. So you simplify it, it become M Cp T2 minus T1. So Q. Okay. How it become? So this we can write PV. So PV, how can we write? PV is equal to MRT. So PV enna pannalana, PV is nothing but MRT. So we know the formula. Just I am writing here. So PV equal to MRT. Just replace with here PV. So it become MR T2 minus T1. Okay, T2 minus T1. So what I know, Cp minus Cv, Cp minus Cv equal to R. Okay, now you consider this two. See here, just if you are putting this on here, so Cv R. So we can write Cv minus R is nothing but Cv plus R is nothing but Cp. So that's why I am putting here. So the MR T2 minus T1 method, you can replace it. So what happening? So MR T2 minus T1. So M update vachikala. The R plus Cv is clear. R plus Cv. I can write as a Cp. Okay. So again T2 minus T1. So this is a heat transfer during the constant pressure process. Remaining everything are same. Okay, wow. So relationship matum pathina P1 V1 by T1 equal to P2 V2 divided by T2. So P1 equal to P2. So the relationship become V1 by T1 equal to V2 by T2. Okay. Next, change in enthalpy. Del H. So del H is nothing but M Cp function of 1 to 2 dt. So it become M Cp T2 minus T1. Okay. So this is a formula for enthalpy. Right. Now we go with the isothermal or constant temperature process. Isothermal or isothermal or constant temperature process. So every temperature constant ah vekka mudiyum ipo paadunga na cylinder vande inga vechirukken சிலிண்டரில் என்ன பண்ணியிருக்கேன்னா பிஸ்டன் வந்து அதிகமாக வச்சுருக்கேன். ஸோ பிஸ்டன் தென் இட் ஃபில்டு வித் சம் அமௌண்ட் ஆஃப் கேஸ். நவ் ஐ எம் அப்ளைங் சம் அமௌண்ட் ஆஃப் ஹீட் ஆன் ஹியர். ஸோ வாட்ஸ் ஹேப்னிங் தட் ஹியர் த கேஸஸ் ஆர் ஹீட்டட் அப் ஸோ தட் த டெம்பரேச்சர் இஸ் ரைசஸ் தென் பிஸ்டன் மூவ்ஸ் அப்வர்ட் டியூ டு ரைசிங் ஆஃப் டெம்பரேச்சர் அண்ட் ப்ரெஷர். ஸோ இன் ஆர்டர் டு மெயின்டைன் எ கான்ஸ்டன்ட் டெம்பரேச்சர் ஐ எம் placing one source, I am placing one source supply on this side, I am placing source supply on this side, this is called as a source. So source is nothing but huge amount of heat it can supply. Okay, so here the temperature remain constant. Okay, in during the process the pressure and the volume change, during the compression, still one, so this is a two. Okay, during the compression generally we can say PV equal to C. So what we know, PV is nothing but MRT, so temperature remain constant, so mass and gas constants are same, so C is the PV equal to C. Okay, now we need to determine the work done. So work done, W is nothing but integration of 1 to 2 P dV. So I want to know what is a P. P V equal to C. So P equal to C by V. So substitute on here 1 to 2 instead of C, V, dV. Okay, so taking away the constant C, it become 1 to 2 dV by V. So substitute the limit, we can write C, so just it become V2 by V1. So instead of C, I can substitute P1, V1, ln of V2 by V1. So this is a formula for work done. Next one, we need to know the change in internal energy. So change in internal energy, what we know, delta equal to M CV integral of 1 to 2 dt. So here temperature is constant, so integrating of any constant becomes 0. So heat Q equal to W plus del U. So Q equal to W. Why? Because the internal energy is zero. In case of enthalpy, del H is nothing but what? Del H is nothing but is also function of MCP integral of dT. So here temperature constant again. So del H also zero. Del H also zero. So what's the value we can do? Relationship with that. So the relationship we know, P1 V1 divided by T1 equal to P2 V2 by T2. So T1 equal to T2. So it become P1 V1 equal to P2 V2 or P1 by P2 equal to V2 by V1. So this is a relationship. Don't memorize any formulas. Just you understand the concept. Okay. Thank you.